Hi everyone, my name is Debbie Van Dormelen.
And I'm Tim Ricks. As environmental biologists, we both study the wildlife that uses the Las Vegas Wash.
Tim and I are out at the wash right now looking for birds and any other wildlife we can find. Monitoring the animals helps us meet the goals of our wildlife management plan, which include conserving native species, protecting their habitats, and increasing awareness in the community.
In addition to general studies, we conduct surveys for federally protected bird species like the endangered southwestern willow flycatcher and threatened yellow-billed cuckoo. Do you know what it means to be a threatened or endangered species? Under the Endangered Species Act, threatened species are those whose populations are declining and are at risk of becoming endangered, while endangered species are those whose populations have declined so much they are at risk of extinction in the near future.
The surveys tell us if these species are present at the Las Vegas Wash, help us estimate their numbers, and with enough years of data, show us any changes over time.
Now you're probably wondering, how do we study these birds? We head out to the wash early in the morning, I'm talking like 4:30 a.m. Then we quietly walk through habitat for the species and broadcast, and then listen for their specific song or call in response. This is known as a call playback survey, where you broadcast the sounds of the target species through a speaker to encourage any individuals in your area to respond. And with more than 200 species of birds using the wash, there can be a lot of bird songs and calls to filter through. If we're lucky enough to see one of these rare birds out in the open, we use our binoculars to get a close look to help with identifying the species.
All of our threatened and endangered bird surveys occur between April and August, because that's when the migrant species are here and when the males are singing, trying to find a girlfriend to nest with. However, we also have a general bird survey that's conducted year-round every 2 weeks.
Another survey we do at the wash is a fish survey. We study fish by placing long nets in the water where the fish get tangled up. We usually place these nets in the afternoon and then check them the next morning, since most fish tend to be more active at night. After we catch the fish, we measure and weigh them and then release them back into the wash. One big difference between our bird surveys and the fish surveys is that none of the fishes in the wash are native to southern Nevada. That means that they're normally found in a different part of the world and have been introduced here.
Other types of wildlife we've surveyed include mammals, reptiles, amphibians, and invertebrates. Through these surveys and the records of citizen scientists through apps like eBird and iNaturalist, we've identified more than 350 species of vertebrate wildlife and 550 species of invertebrate wildlife.
Over two decades, the Las Vegas Wash Coordination Committee built 21 weirs to stabilize the channel and improve the water quality of the wash. And now we need to maintain those structures. This requires a lot of big equipment. We conduct special monitoring for the federally threatened desert tortoise to make sure construction doesn't impact it. And we conduct the other wildlife surveys to see how populations change over time in response to the stabilization program. The data shows a strong positive response to the restoration of the Las Vegas Wash.
You can even do your own surveys at the wash. Next time you're here, write down all the species that you can identify or enter them into an app like iNaturalist. Then do this every time you go back to the wash. After a few visits, you should have a nice list of species.